Hey everybody, I don't know who will actually get to join. I didn't really give a heads up on this, but this is kind of, I think there's a description to this live, but I'll tell you what I'm going live about. This is really just an intro. I've been talking to several people in the group and on my page and various other places about a live that I'm going to do later this week. Either Thursday, which I think tomorrow's Thursday, or Friday. Probably I'll try to do it on Thursday. But I thought I would go ahead and go on and give you an intro to what I'm going to talk about. And if you will, guys, someone that's on, looks like there's a few people on, could you give me a heart or any kind of emoji just so that I know you can actually hear me? So I'm doing this in my car. So I hope there's an audio. I'm pretty sure there should be. So I now see, there we go, there's a thumbs up. I now see why so many people do their videos in the car. It's like one of the only places where you can get away and it's quiet. I do have the air conditioner running, so hopefully you can't hear that. But without further ado, let me give you an idea of what I'm talking about, and then what the live on Friday will be. I do have some notes with me here as well, so I may look down and read from those every once in a while. I've been basically working in this Facebook Messenger marketing / automation area for almost 8 months now, so I do have some experience. I've been able to see how this is working, been able to do a lot of studying with regards to the industry and how they're using it. So I thought it was time to start sharing with other people how they could use it. So let me just start by kind of sharing some basics about Facebook Messenger, some statistics that I think will be helpful. We'll talk more about the why right now in this live, talk more about the how probably when I do the live on Thursday or Friday. But Facebook, back I think around 2016, basically began to start using Facebook Messenger, or allowing people to use Facebook Messenger to communicate in a, like, from a business to a consumer type of environment. It's been around for a while where people could, you know, chat, that type of thing. But anyway, it's still relatively new. A lot of businesses are really not using it, and so for those that do start using it, you're going to really be an early adopter, but you're going to be glad that you did. So just to kind of give you some context, I started using this for our Young Living business right around the Thanksgiving time frame for Black Friday, so we used it a lot to be able to communicate with our team. There's so many uses, though, so I'll generally say we've used it mostly for communication with our team, being able to share with them promos, being able to follow up with them after they got their starter kit, any type of follow-up that you can imagine. The thing that makes Messenger different, though, is it's very media-rich. So what I mean by that is you can send inline videos, audios, you can send files like a PDF file. Those of you that have already joined my VIP list, you've kind of seen part of what you can do, because I've basically had set up what might traditionally be called a drip campaign, where you're getting messages from me, you know, every 15 minutes, and then a 40 after 40 minutes, another one after 40 minutes, another one after an hour, another one. I've done that for two reasons. I didn't want to overwhelm you with information, for one, just blast it all out there at one time. I also wanted you to see some context, how you could basically do that. So imagine, for example, you've got a new member that just got their premium starter kit, and you want to send them a message a day, which talks about one of the oils that's in the premium starter kit. And also, of course, Nyxia Red would be involved in that. Thieves would be involved in that. You could completely automate that. Basically, the minute that they subscribe to your Messenger platform, then they could start that schedule where it would be automatically sent to them. So the key is obviously to get your team members even prospects for that matter, but team members subscribed to your messenger. So I'm going to talk about all the hows later, but so I'm going to talk as though it's already set up, but so don't get too caught up in the hows. So there is some technology involved in this. You can't just start doing this with the messenger app and without anything else. So but also don't get too concerned about that. We're not talking about thousands of dollars to get this going. We're talking about, hundreds, and even at hundreds, I mean, that's depending on how much you want to do with it. So let's get back off of that for a moment, but let's talk about where messenger marketing and automation is headed, or one of the other terms that's used a lot in the industry is communicative marketing, in other words, or conversational marketing. So I posted a while back a article about what's called dark social, and that term was coined a while back in an Atlantic Magazine article. But nonetheless, dark social is basically this concept where people have been gravitating away from your traditional social media networks to share information. They're still using social media networks, don't get me wrong, but to share links, to share information. They're turning to, believe it or not, email. Some the different messaging apps like Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp is another one that's bigger in Europe and in India and those parts of the world, and Instagram to a less extent because it has some messaging capabilities. But here's one of the reasons you want to jump on this and be an early adopter. Facebook, if you may or may not know, but Facebook obviously owns Facebook and Facebook Messenger. They also own Instagram, and they also own WhatsApp. So that's three of the top four messaging apps in the world. And so that right there represents easily 4 billion users. That's, yeah, 4 billion users. So you've got North America covered with Facebook Messenger. Of course, it's used in other parts of the world. You've got Asia, except for China, using WhatsApp a lot, and then Instagram. And you have to look no further than China with what they call WeChat to get an idea of where things are headed. They, with what's called WeChat, most every consumer there, most every citizen that has a smartphone or a computer that's online, they pay their bills that way. They interact with companies that way. They really don't even visit websites much anymore. A website becomes now a place where you refer to once you've got started with that conversation. So where websites will still be important is lengthy communication, but the way that you will engage people in that lengthy communication, if you will, or that article about, for example, since a lot of us are Young Living, that article about your digestive system, for example, and Digize, or Ningxia Red as an antioxidant, and all the things that you would want to communicate about that. You would not put all of that in Messenger, but you would create an environment where that's where they would initially go. So those of you that are already in my Messenger platform, you could, for example, type YL menu, the all together, the letters YL for Young Living, and then menu, and you would see kind of what I'm talking about. This is something we're using where people can, for example, find out about what Seed to Seal is. They can find out about Young Living, the history of Young Living. They can find out about the Premium Starter Kit, and there's a referral link there if this is a prospect as opposed to a team member, where they could actually enroll in Young Living, and obviously our member number is in there. So let's talk a little bit more now about the future and where we're headed. So it's a very bold statement, what I'm about to say, and it's somewhat biased from those that are developing tools to allow you to exploit Messenger. But the consensus among those folks is that, basically Messenger apps and Facebook Messenger would be a big part of that, will basically, make email obsolete. It'll still be around, but it will be obsolete. It's already obsolete in many ways because the open rates for emails are really, really low. Emails, phone calls, obviously we already know those are very not used much anymore. SMS or text messages, your traditional text messages, are already in many cases when you read the research is going down as far as its use, because the reason is you we go where people are, and the reality is with, like I said, over 4 billion people using 3 of the messaging apps that Facebook has, that's where a majority of the people are. There's nothing to install. I mean, most people already have that. So it's really a matter of you going to where your customers are, to where your team members are, and to where your prospects are. And the other thing I'll say is I've done a fair amount of research. Now, I'm not a millennial, and I love millennials, but there's a lot of concern, a lot of buzz out there about how do we reach millennials, right? And this talk about how, they're all on Instagram. Well, the statistics certainly say, yes, that's true, but the same statistics also say that they're still on Facebook, at least for messaging. And so with Facebook Messenger, for example, you don't even have to have a Facebook account. You can actually install Facebook Messenger and authenticate the use of it with your phone number. And so the reality is with Facebook Messenger and them having the top 3 apps, let me give you or paint a picture of the future and why you want to be an early adopter, be one of the first ones to do this. So again, since Facebook owns Facebook Messenger, owns Instagram, and owns WhatsApp, they have basically said that they're going to open up WhatsApp and Instagram already, and Facebook Messenger already opened up, where you will have a single way and to be able to communicate to all Instagram users, all WhatsApp users, and all Facebook Messenger users, all through one interface. And the leading company doing that, which is what I use, they'll be right there. They are the leading company that allows you to automate all of this. And I'll talk through that more on Friday or Thursday whenever I do the video. And here's the icing on the cake. So I'd mentioned that SMS, this is, based upon all the research I've done, I also believe that although it's not dead, that the lion's share of communication will be through SMS. One person is estimating 80% of the users out there will use that. So that really kind of makes it the channel instead of one of many channels. It would certainly become the primary channel with which people communicate. So, with that being the case, you're going to be able to send messages to people basically in their preferred platform. If they're a WhatsApp kind of person, you're still going to be able to, from a single application, be able to send them notifications. Same for Instagram, same for Facebook Messenger. So, and then the icing that I said was on the cake, with SMS kind of being superseded by what's called RCS, which is Rich Communication Services. I believe it's RCS. Google has been the driving force behind that, and they're working with carriers, phone carriers, that is, to embrace that. And once that is accepted as the norm, that will basically bring the equivalent of SMS into the new age, where you're, where you have media-rich environments. And so RCS will also be a part of this broader central capability, so you'll be able to send, in essence, through one interface, through one platform, messages to through RCS, which is would be similar to SMS, to WhatsApp, to Facebook Messenger, to Instagram. And I left out one other, and this is a big one, Apple, excuse me, I'm trying to make sure I gather all my thoughts. Apple has iMessage. If you've got an iPhone, you're familiar with iMessage. I don't really think of it so much as iMessage, but when you're texting on an Apple, by and large, you're doing that through iMessage unless you turn it off. That is also being opened up. Apple is going to open that up. This will also be eventually integrated. So you'll, again, that's why I'm saying, and that's why the experts are saying, this will messaging through Facebook Messenger and then connected, integrated to those other channels, then really becomes the single channel, because from one place you can communicate to all of those people. I'm going to look at my notes and tell you a few other statistics. This is probably something you already know, and another reason you want to probably be embracing Facebook Messenger is the fact that almost 60% of internet traffic on a day-to-day basis is through a smartphone. So Facebook Messenger is optimized for mobile communications using through a mobile device. So again, the user experience is very very nice. It's not like you're trying to simulate a web page on a phone, so that will also make it much more acceptable. Let me look as well. A couple of other statistics. Consumers are already exchanging, this is crazy, right? 2 billion messages with businesses each month on Facebook Messenger. So, again, I'm going to talk about one other thing. So, again, this concern about millennials, and the focus on millennials, I think, is mainly because, they obviously represent the future of a big part of the future of those that will be buying things, consuming. So just want you to know that, again, I'm really repeating myself here, but Facebook Messenger is actually one of the top apps that's used amongst millennials. It's actually above Instagram as far as its use. So I got a lot of backup research that I could show you. I'm not going to be able to show you that through this phone, but there's a lot of data points that actually prove that out. So let's see, what else do I want to share? Oh, I do want to cover one other thing. So here recently, about, I guess, 10 days ago, and now this video is, I know, going kind of long. I said it was an intro, but about 10 days ago, if I'm counting right, maybe less, Tony Robbins, and I'm just going to say Tony Robbins. There were two other guys with him on this online webinar, but he was the biggest name. But they had been pushing this webcast that they were going to do, marketing it, and one of the key tools that they used to broadcast this out, to communicate, to remind people, to send them notifications that the webcast was coming up, was to use Facebook Messenger. It was the largest online event in internet history, based upon what I've been told. 250 people actually watched the webcast. They've now had a second, and now they're on a third reshowing of it. So Facebook Messenger was used for over 50,000 of those people signed up basically through Facebook Messenger to receive all of their notifications, the reminders that it was coming up. And the way this worked is, since it was this campaign of building up until the day of the webcast, they basically sent out each day or every other day a short video leading up to the actual event. So that should give you also, I think, an indication of how some of the biggest names in the industry are embracing Facebook Messenger. They also used traditional methods, email, SMS, but Facebook Messenger was a big, big part of what they were doing. So I think I'm getting close to the end here. Let me look and see. I took a few other notes. I want to talk just briefly about key times in history, because I think we're also at a key time in history with regards to decisions that you're going to make regarding how you choose to, on a mass scale, again, communicate with multiple people, but yet where it feels personal. So some of those key times in history, and I'm talking about key times in history with regards to technology. If you haven't figured it out by now, I'm an IT guy, so I have an IT background, a lot of business background as well, but over 20 plus years in working with Fortune 100 companies, implementing, you know, information technology to, you know, for business transformation. So I do have some context. But so some of the key times in history, for example, IBM, most of you probably know IBM obviously came out with what was called the mainframe, then a mid-range computer. But when the personal computer idea kind of came out, IBM thought, that's stupid. Who needs a personal computer, right? They were into selling these massive computers, both in size and capacity. They thought, why would a personal user, why would a person need a PC or a personal computer? And so they missed the bandwagon on that. And honestly, from a personal computer, a desktop computer standpoint, they never recovered from that. They never really had the lion's share of personal computer sales. You would probably remember the names Dell and Compaq and HP and various other, Acer, all of those. So they missed the bandwagon on that. Now, they did learn from their mistakes, and they did take a big portion of the laptop industry, but again, mostly focused for business users. Their ThinkPad did really well. So that's an example of where a company missed the opportunity that they had to get in early, and they never recovered from it. Another one is Microsoft and the internet browser. So when the internet became popular, some of you may remember companies like Netscape and some others that I can't even remember. Netscape was one of the earliest ones. And then, that was one of the early ones. Some others came out. Of course, Google finally came out with theirs, Chrome. But Microsoft was visibly absent. They kind of, like IBM said, why would someone need a browser to get on the internet? I mean, the internet is used for, you know, education and research, right? But little did they know, look where we're at now with the internet. Now, they, again, have come out with a browser, but they're still behind the curve. It's still not the biggest one used. Google Chrome, I would say, for the most part, is the one mostly used. So that's just some point. Blockbuster. So this is IT related. Blockbuster. Look at Blockbuster. They went out of business because they let companies like Netflix and now Amazon, and there's several others, right, that you basically made it to where you could watch TV anytime you wanted, anywhere you wanted, movies anytime you want, anywhere you want, without commercials, without having to get up and go drive and pick out a video. So they had their day in the sun, as they say, but they don't exist anymore because they didn't adapt. So another one is taxis. Taxis still exist, obviously, but look at what Uber and Lyft has done. It's totally transformed transportation with regards to taxis versus these other options. Many of you that are going, that are Young Living, that are going to the convention, and you are likely to use an Uber, so, or Lyft. I actually used one for the first time when we went to a convention 2 years ago. So I live out in the country, so I don't need to use something like a taxi that often. And normally when I travel, I get a rental car if it's for business. But those are examples. So I bring all that up to say that I think we're at another pivotal point where this is truly an early adopter opportunity. You're likely not hearing a lot of people talk about how massive this is going to be, how pervasive it's going to be. I'll give you a few other examples to show how important Facebook, for example, thinks this is. Regardless of what you think about Facebook, for example, I say for a moment, they don't have the best of reputations for privacy, so forth and so on. But 4 billion people speak loudly. We just if we're going to talk about being where the consumers are, then we can set aside for a moment our thoughts about Facebook and say, if that's where people are at, then Facebook still has a place in our society. And so that being the case, they just had their developers conference, actually, I think like 3 days ago. And over again in the keynote speech, actually, that Mark Zuckerberg gave on the first day, it was privacy is the future and personal is the future. So in other words, the future is, over and over again, they were talking about features that they're adding to Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, and Instagram to make it more personal, to make it more private, to make it more secure. So Facebook is fundamentally shifting, although Facebook, the network, if you will, Instagram, those type of things will continue to be around. Messenger is at the forefront of where Facebook is going, and it's where the innovation will be. So these are all kind of introductory type thoughts. I hope this will give you some thoughts for why you want to join the live that I'll do either Thursday or Friday. I'm sorry, I can't tell you exactly when right now. I'll try to give you as much advance notice as possible. And I do encourage you to join live if you can, because I'm going to try to walk you through some things that you can kind of see how Messenger works. So the other thing I'll ask is if it's possible to join the Facebook Live when I actually do it. If you have both a computer that can be on the internet and a phone, I would encourage you to join the live on your computer if that's possible, and then keep your phone available so you can actually go through some of the Messenger automation that I already have, so you can actually kind of see it live and in real time. So this has been a fairly long video. I appreciate those of you that have stuck with me, those that have joined. So if you will, in this down below, give me some hints about, or questions that you have, comments that you have, that will help inform me when I do go live. So there's things that I want to talk about, things that I need to have to get said, but then I also want to answer questions that you might have. I've sent many of you, and if you join, I've sent, put a link in there. If it didn't end up being in there, I'll go back and add the link. Go on that link. No surprise, that's a Messenger link that'll basically connect you with my Facebook Messenger channel. It will then start dripping you some information, giving you some key bites of information about this technology. And in that is a YouTube video. Go to that YouTube video, watch it. Put comments in there if you want, or put them all here. I guess my point is, I would love to hear the questions that you have about this, so that I can hopefully answer some of them when we go live again later this week. Probably will not be able to answer them all, but I will do my best. And again, I certainly appreciate your time and value that. So hope this benefits you some. You guys have a great day. All right, bye.